Hey folks, it's an easygoing Saturday night. It's time to relax. So let's play some more Graceful Explosion Machine. We dove into it twice, and we've got some exploring to do in the last two worlds. So let's wrap that up, because I really, really like this game. But first, let's see, am I still the queen of Magento's Prime? Nope. Oh well. For a brief moment, at the start of last Friday, I was number one on all of these boards. But hey, other people are playing and that's totally fine, so let's keep going. We still need to finish Scarlet Epsilon. So let's get to it. If this is your first time seeing Graceful Explosion Machine, it's a... Ow. It is a Defender-like side-scrolling shooter. And I have a little like gun like this, and it overheats, and eventually it goes like, it doesn't work anymore. So I had to let it. I have some other weapons. I have the sword, which is really, really useful. I have the sniper beam. It's very cool, but it needs some time on each enemy to do damage, so it's not very good against groups. And I have missiles. And they're homing missiles, and they just do some great stuff. And basically, all of these weapons, except my little pea shooter, they all pull from a common pool of energy. And I need to replenish it by grabbing those little yellow things that enemies drop. And so I have to be careful and kind of use a mix of all of my weapons to make sure that I can still keep collecting and shooting and damaging and dying. So that's how that works. Let's keep trying. Each level has three phases and off we go. Basically also there's a multiplier. It's in the top right. And I'm in the top right. That's not gonna work. Boop. There I am. So. Okay. Now you get to see it. So yeah, there's a little multiplier. If I spend too much time not destroying enemies, it will reset back to one. So I have to keep gracefully exploding everything I can, making sure there's not too big a lull. And here's the thing also, on the right hand side there's a bonus for how many enemies I can kill in a single volley, so I want that to be pretty big. And see, I took too long again to kill some enemies, so now my multiplier is restarting. So getting to be the best at this game takes a lot of skill. Because, you know, it's... You have to keep doing this kind of thing and also manage your energy, not get hit. Because if you get hit, you lose everything, score-wise at least. And so on and so forth. But really, right now, our goal is mainly just to survive. And even that can be a challenge when this is your first time in this level. Because you don't know everything. You don't know, like, which... What the waves are gonna be like, you don't know. Maybe there's new enemies. I think there was a new enemy in this one that I didn't really get the chance to get to know. There we go. So let's see. All right, that's gonna be fun. There we go. I love those little tadpole-y critters because they're always good for a lot of combos. And oh gosh, that's a lot of stuff happening right now. Okay. You can use like a weapon once when you don't have the energy, and then you're in this like bad state. So you kind of have to like bet, can I get my energy back the way I am now? if I'm gonna be, like, unable to use anything other than my little blaster for a little bit. Like, there's so much depth to this game, but you can just play it like a shooter and just see, now I'm just gonna try to, you know, survive. And that's totally valid. It's, you know, you get to discover new worlds, explore, and if you want it, there is depth waiting for you. Ah, right in the face. See, and I have a very aggressive playstyle. I get right up in the face of all my little alien friends. So I have to be like, it's very high risk, high reward, and sometimes high risk, no reward, because I get smacked in the face. But everything, like the vibrations, the little pauses when you really hurt an enemy, oh, that was dumb of me. Like, it's, everything feels so rewarding with this game, and I have trouble stopping playing it at some point. Like, there will be time where I just say, okay, I'm just gonna try to get a high score on this level, and I'm just gonna keep playing and playing and playing forever. Now I can restart from the beginning of this phase, but I only have a certain amount of tries to do that. There's just those little intricacies like, some enemies have shields, and you need sustained damage to pierce through it, so you need to use the sniper against them. Other enemies like to shoot projectiles, and the sword will stop those colds, so you need to use that against them. And sometimes you just want to unload it in pretty much everybody's general direction, and that's real satisfying as well. That was a gamble when I figured, okay, yeah, I can get back into this situation. Oh, that's a lot of folks. This is a popular little, ow, yep, that was too many enemies. Too many happy little aliens. Oh, come on, you made it out? There we go. Ideally, you want to do everything in a single combo. That's hard. Whoops, nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's go over here. Also, sometimes the levels aren't fully opened up yet, and you get kinda, so you start in a corner. You can also dash. That lets you go through enemies, but not bullets. Alright, first phase. Ah, okay, see, now the level's opening up a little bit between phases. That's really cool. Oh, right, I forgot I didn't have any energy. Well, that's bad. You have to take care of yourself and, you know, maintain your energy. That's a good lesson. Oh, that's a big one. All right, so these folks are gonna be shooting at me. I'm gonna need the sniper to deal with them. but for that I'm gonna need some energy. And see, they have this big old shield. There we go. So we just take over one of these. We deal with, you know, a bunch of these happy little enemies just crowding us in. And you slowly try to tread water, get some power back, until you can basically get yourself out of this corner. But that can be real hard. And all this time dodging shots and blocking shots from the big guy upstairs, and all of this basically trying to get into a position where you can do this. Oh, but we missed the last shot. Thankfully, we were kind of able to save it, but not without getting hit, so we lost all of our multiplier. But we'd still survive, and that's the important thing right now. So imagine doing all of that without getting hit and without losing that multiplier. And that's where the, like, advanced stages of this game come in. And it's what I really like about it, despite how, you know, rather stressful it can appear to be. I'm just gonna straight over here. And did you notice, my little sword kind of followed me when I dashed. That's a thing I didn't know. See how cool that is? You can totally do this kind of thing. I'm gonna have to experiment with that, because I didn't realize that was a thing. Help. And I'm dead. Well, let's try that again. Now I'm curious. No, wrong button. Ow. That was quick. I died real fast. Maybe let's take a less cavalier approach to this. Let's take care of these folks first. There we go. All right, that's good. So while it does look like you can get stuck in a corner, you can also find your way out of it. These levels are really getting hairy, and I really like that. Like, when it gets a challenge just to survive, then you can imagine how interesting it's gonna be to work out how to get, like, a good score. And that's the great thing about it, is, like, it kind of feels like a puzzle. See, I lost my... lost my multiplier, but like, yeah, it takes a lot of shots to get those folks down. That's right, not the best though, still. Wait, no, not. Yeah, like, that's 500,000. That is not necessary. But yeah, that's... with, like, exponential score rewards, when you can take care of a bunch of enemies at once, like, this game is gonna be interesting to follow on the leaderboards. Ah, I meant to dash, but just wasn't quick enough. Okay, that was on me. Also, if you notice, in the lower left, there's like little emojis to kind of like show how your pilot's feeling right now. I don't actually have time to look at it at any point when I'm playing, but I know it's pretty nifty. Okay, I just need to figure out which button I want to press here. I'm getting a little bit flustered. Well. Maybe, like, you know, jumping right in the middle of a ton of enemies is not the right strategy. I probably said this a lot during my streams of this game, and I still keep doing it. Possibly because I like doing it, and, you know, it's hard to convince the part of me that is really rewarded by this game that, oh no, you really should just stop doing this thing altogether. I'm gonna start the next phase without power. And oh no, there we go, it's recharged a little bit. Like, the sword can be super important for getting at enemies who are just not to the left or the right of you. Sometimes you just need a way to die immediately. Well, that was bad. Alright, we got this. Hello? Goodbye. Of a break. We're just gonna, like, blow up some enemies the good old-fashioned way. And the great thing is, like, oh, you can't just keep using one thing over and over again because your various systems have different energy mechanics and cooldowns, so you kind of have to keep them both, like, active to find the optimum way to navigate this game. Because, like, your main blaster will eventually overheat, and all your weapons will run out of energy, so you have to kind of juggle them to find a good middle ground. Oh, that's a, oh, right, those, I really dislike those folks, because they do that. They become invincible, and then they rush you. There we go. Really love the, like, everything is geometric shapes, but everything's just so adorable too, and just like, it's very rewarding. Oh right, there's lasers. Lasers are bad. They're gonna make our lives a little bit tricky. Right, laser. That's what I mean by making our lives a little bit tricky. Sometimes, yeah, you also die sometimes. Alright, we got this though. Alright, lasers. Just gotta remember where the lasers are. Don't actually, you know, rush into bullets. That's a bad thing. And also, just look at all the different explosions of the different enemies and how everything layers so well together visually. This is a beautiful game. Ow. You can't dash through lasers. Okay, well, gonna have to restart the game. We're gonna get it this time back. The fact that enemies drop the power you need to use your weapons kind of means that you're constantly moving. You can engage them at a distance, but you kind of have to go where they were to get your juice, and that keeps going on. It also means that, like, the sniper laser is pretty good, but it requires you to get a move on. Alright, phase one done. Let's keep going. Whew. See, I wanted to hit one of those little folks so I could keep my multiplier going, which they... They parted ways and just would not let me destroy one of them. That was unexpected, but let's keep going. Also, yeah, the sword will push enemies away, but if you just ram them, it's still gonna hurt. Ah, gosh. Okay, good thing I grabbed that health then, right before I got hit. What? Ah, hate that blue centipede. Yeah, 12 gear. Invincible rushing is just rude. Missiles are deceptively useful, because also it's relatively easy to get your fuel back from unleashing like a big old salvo. She says, immediately unable to do this right after using it. Phase 3. And also with the lasers, you kind of have to, like, be real careful about where you corral the enemies. Because you might get cut off from everything, and then you can't destroy an enemy to keep your multiplier going. Of course, if you just ram them like I do, then you die. Thought I had that one. Arrgh. We will not be defeated by 3-8. I was real close though. I was real close on that one. Why did I do that? That was a bit dumb. Also the little sound when you lose your multiplier is the saddest thing, and it hurts every time I hear it. There we go. Sometimes I will totally just use a sword just so I can finish off some of the little folks, because they can be so hard to actually hit. And you don't want to lose your multiplier because you just couldn't hit little green guy. Nothing out of that, really? Such a sad sound, it hurts every time. Ow. Yeah, the missile swarms feel very anime. I like them a lot. Right, probably move when you're getting shot at. That's... Alright. We have some more lives. We got this. We can do this. Okay, yeah. Missiles. Missiles working well against these folks. Thank you. Come on, I was doing so well. Big meanie. Okay, no joke, let's just stay alive then. Now the enemy's left counter has come up, so we're close to the end. Gosh, that was way too close. I completely forgot about the laser again. Don't forget about the laser. We did it! That is a pitiful news high score, though. Yeah, I'll submit it. Might as well. Alright, now we get to warp. The warp is pretty interesting in that it never ends. Oh gosh, that's a big fella. It's basically, like, warps are giant, never-ending battle. Well, they do end, but, like, they're pretty big. Gosh, that's a lot. Alright, good. Yeah, the big ones with shields, it's real hard to do any sort of lasting harm to them without resorting to missiles. Also, it's hard to get to use the sniper when there's a bunch of little enemies who will just keep swarming you and kind of block the path. So yeah, you're just trying to, like, get some power so you can use your big thing. There we go. That's gonna help. And, oh, by the way, the little enemies there will explode and hurt you. And they also split into tinier enemies, so hey, that's good, right? Oh, see, I wandered into the explosion. Don't wander into the explosion, kids. That's bad. Oh, come on, little fry, I was doing so well. Good. Yep. Hit someone that exploded on me. So yeah, it's enemy management in a constant swarm of enemies. That's what the warp zones are, and they're real good. I'm way into them. Provided I can actually survive them, you know, ow. Nope, I kind of lost track of my ship there. There we go. Manage the swarms. Hit the big folks. Don't get completely overwhelmed by the... Aw, come on, you big jerk. I was in the middle of explaining something important. Basically, you need to have eyes everywhere. It's simple. It's not easy, it's simple, though. No, you... Okay. All right. Alright, thumbs up, we're back in the game. Okay, now all the little swarmers are gonna make it impossible to actually hit big spiky thing. That's gonna be a bummer. Again? Hey guys, I'm actually trying to get something accomplished here. If you would indulge me for just a moment. But they don't, they just keep coming forever. There we go. Thank you. Is that so hard? Eventually you catch a good groove. Okay, yeah, I think I got this. But then the folks what explode come back and you remember, right, those folks suck. See, the dash was already engaged, but it was just too late. All right, ones that explode, please move away from me. Okay, I think I got him. And another one. No, don't sword the enemy that explodes. That's okay, there we go. Keep treading water. No, I know you really want to poke me there. I see you. Thank goodness. All right, good. And there we go. Hey, go. Hey, by the way, this game is hard. So yeah, imagine like just keeping one combo going through this entire thing. It's gotta be fun though. I can't lie, I will eventually try it. And now we get the challenge mode for this world, but let's explore the whys and how of Aurum Tau. Hey, it's a gold planet. That's gotta be cool, right? And already, we are starting strong here. Gosh. See, when even the sword isn't enough to keep enemies away. That's a lot of enemies. First phase, second level. This world is going to be interesting. Alright. That bullet really... Okay, Xandra, maybe start watching out for yourself a little bit, okay? Yep, grab that. Okay, good. That is just too many enemies. Yeah, even the sword isn't enough to keep the bunch at bay. Gosh, that's overwhelming. That is a new level of being way past the whelming point. Boop. Yeah, 12th gear. This is a good metaphor for managing our inbox. Oh, right in the face. Well, that's gonna be tricky. All right. I think that was a good strategy. You get two dashes before you have to wait for them to recharge, and that's pretty good, because you can dash in, grab some gems, and then dash right back out. Alright, those little blue, I'm gonna need to find a polite term to refer to them. They will dash away from your shots. That makes them very, very annoying. Makes missiles usually a good solution for them. Okay, I'm in the wrong place to start attacking that one. That one, though. Right, you can't dash through bullets. All right. But now I start on the right side of this one, so I can just dispatch it right away. And that's gonna leave me a clear avenue of escape if I want to just, you know, get the heck away. Alright, buddy, it's your turn. Hey, we did it! Bored Arm Horror is a pretty good name for that. Hey, that was the second level of this world. Okay, what's gonna be new this time? Alright, today is, gosh, that's a lot of those little folks. I'm hearing a sound off in the distance and, oh, okay, that's... Don't really remember what that one does. Gonna kill it from a distance. I think that's a reasonable thing to do. Oh, okay, it makes explosions. The things I really don't like, it makes those. Alright, so far so good. And I got a little rainbow! I do like that enemies kind of seem to be like spreading apart around your wake when you dash, and just like, oh gosh, we should probably get out of here. Can't really run away if I shoot you point blank, though, is the thing. Oh, got a perfect phase. That's real good. It's even better if I do it the whole level, not just at the end of the second phase, but, you know. Well, I just threw it all away. I just love everything, like... Like, everything is exploding, but it's all cute little diamond shapes of different, slightly different colors, and they all kind of, like, look super well together, and... I really like how elegant this whole, like, visual brand is. And I'm dead. We got this, though. Alright, we have the initial onslaught of the little guys. Little folks. Little teal terrors. Ow. Okay, I'm in a bad way here. You need to stop existing. There we go. Oh, crap. Didn't notice him there. Thank you. Right, I need to get... Yeah, I need to just, like... dive right into the other one. Alright, that went bad. One down. Got some health, that's good. First you, and then you. Whew. Thanks for dropping by, Aria. Yeah, this was... I stopped talking for a moment because it got real hard. But this is probably my favorite world name, because it sounds so good. Orum Tau. That's such a good name. Yeah. Alright, I need to get rid of this one. There we go. I also need to survive the exit. Also, to get the real good scores, you want to destroy as many enemies as possible in a single attack. But that means spending some time to position yourself, and that means you might let the timer run out on your multiplier. So there's a very high skill ceiling in this game, and it's very, very, very interesting. I'm real eager to see some replays of, like, the top scores. Okay, that's not gonna work. Okay, he can reach me there, and I can maybe not reach him. Alright, that's gonna be... Oh, okay, yeah, I can reach him from the other side. Laser from the other side. Alright, good. Everything's going wrong right now. I need to get away from there. You need to get away from living. Nope, can't reach him from there. There we go. Simple, efficient, Zandra. No, that's not actually a good slogan for me. I'm not actually simple nor efficient. Those do not describe me, turns out. With those purple pointy triangles is that they will sometimes just shoot, and if you're in the middle of a dash, well, you can't dash through shots. Big spiky's back. Also, it's kind of neat that you get all of your weapons, everything you will ever need for the entire game, right in the first couple of levels, and then the rest is just, well, okay, here are different circumstances in which you get to use them. And that's all it takes, really. Like, some good level design and management of pacing of waves and enemies and combinations. Well, that's level design, really. Take you down with missiles. Yeah, sort of. Cool. Good enough. Oh my gosh. Alright. Oh! That's a new one. Of course he's got a shield. Okay. That's interesting. What is interesting is that they put a bunch of them together at the same time. Right, right, I have no more energy. Okay. Oh, now this makes it interesting because now those shots are gonna reach further and I'm not gonna have cover against them. That's clever. That's real clever, level designer. That's such a good idea. Yeah, you start with like some little pieces of cover and you remove them. It's really just you change a little bit how the level looks. But depending on the enemies you put into the arena, that changes like your relationship to whether or not you perceive this as a good thing. Oh. Really meant to just like hit them. I also love that you can just hold down the button and just keep shooting missiles until you have no more power. It's just, yeah, just keep those missiles going. How do I get, like, hit twice in the first 30 seconds of a level? Bucket of unfun. Alright. Mm-hmm. please go away. Look how cool the blue folks animate, though, when they're about to, like, rush you. Isn't that... It's a very cool multi-part animation with some good anticipation. It's just... There's so much to love about this. Okay. I'm glad I didn't do my double play stream today, because like that would, I could not have been sustaining this level. Four levels left. We got this. Like the exploding one. Cannot just like articulate just how much I don't like the one that explodes. Is cute in a very fantasy zone kind of way. Thank you. And I love how you can do most of this game. You don't really need to look much at the UI, you can tell by sound how you're doing. Like when your blaster starts overheating, you hear it before it's too late, so you can actually, like, adjust. Oh my gosh, we're almost there. This, oh, horizontal laser, that's new. Get rid of those folks first. Oh, that was the last one. Okay. Let's just pretend that never happened and just keep going. Also, I don't make a big enough deal of how just perfect the control over your little craft is. Like, you have just the right amount of speed and maneuverability to pretty much do what you gotta do. Whoops. Speed and maneuverability weren't the issue here. That was just some bad stuff happened. Alright, that's a lot of stuff here. Maybe fewer shots. How about that, folks? Like, can we just, like, put a moratorium out on shots? Right, you can't dash through shots. Keep forgetting. Let alone getting a good shot, a good score. Just surviving is a big deal in this one. Alright, final regular level before the warp. We're gonna get a big surprise. Lucky little bugger. Yeah, let's try that again. Oh, I totally didn't see the laser there. That was bizarre. Yep, I think I'm getting tired. All right. For real this time. I'm surprised I survived that. Lasers are getting annoying. I didn't say more lasers, just fine. I thought I kind of made it clear I was like specifically going in the direction of no more lasers. I had to run into that last bullet, that's just... Okay, Oh, final phase, okay. Yeah, that's right, Tolkir. Surviving is the only score that matters. Can't have the highest score if you're dead. Come on, let me give me a shot here. There we go. Didn't realize he'd actually done another bomb before. All right, we got this. Get away from the laser! Get rid of that one real soon. Also, something interesting I've kind of noticed. If you use a power when your juice bar is really low, you will actually go in debt. So it's gonna stay empty until you earn enough power to get back into the positive. That's why sometimes it stays empty for a while, is because, oh, I was overdrawn at the ammunition bank. See, now it takes a bit. To actually get back to where I was. Unless I misunderstood the whole thing completely, but I've seen a few times where I really had to get a bunch of power just to be able to recover any sort of ability to shoot. We did it! This game gets hard, folks! Alright, well, warp 4, the big one. Let's see how this looks. And we got a more boss-like music track too, that's pretty cool. Finally! There we go. See, now, like, it took me a while to even get back into the positive there. Probably something there. Unless I'm misunderstanding, but I feel there's part of it. I could probably just ask the folks who made the game to see if that's how it works. I'm curious now. That's gonna be a big, yep, that's a big spiky. Alright, how am I gonna get rid of you? Other side. Ow! What gives? Right? That doesn't work. Yeah, gotta be careful of the overdraft charges. Fighting for your life on Aurum Tau. Oh, they're removing parts of the level as we go. That's interesting. Even though this one technically doesn't have any phases, it kind of works like one. Oh, that's bad. Well, the worst times to lose power. Goodbye. Whoops. That was close. And there's also a challenge mode where you get to play all the levels in one go. Like, that's cool. That's not at all impossible. Yeah, that was a bit much. Come on, stop escaping me. There are a few things as infuriating as like enemies that will actively run away from you when your job is to destroy them. That's real bad. Like, let me do my job! Yep, that's bad. I'm in a bad place. Is there only one left? Did it! Oh my gosh. Gosh, that took a lot out of me. This game is a trip. That's right, the whole game we were going to recover those gems that were taken from the mothership by those bad aliens. I forgot about the story. Oh my gosh, what's happening? Aww. Made a warp back home. So good. Oh, even Earth was happy to see the little ship come back. Hey, Mobeen, Gabby, Robbie, Henry, Nina, you made a really good game. That was a great experience, and I'm still gonna keep playing it because I need to. I need to, you know, come back in the leaderboard in some fashion. And also, it's just like, that's a great game on the go. Just, you know, challenge modes for Arm Tau. Gosh, can you even imagine? Like, oh yeah, just like score attack the whole thing or warp 4 plus. What's the leaderboard like for Warp 4 Plus? Three people! Yeah, nearby, no one. Friends, no one. World, three people finished that. That's something. So that was Graceful Explosion Machine. I'm gonna have to take a break from this game because my fingers hurt. I hope you had fun watching me gracefully explode so many, many aliens. Yep. That was a fun time. So, if you're watching the stream, I'm gonna switch into something else, but if not, please continue taking care of yourselves because you're very important. And until we see each other again in another distant galaxy, in a particularly graceful machine, let's keep making wonderful things together. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.